Are you completely overwhelmed by all of the tasks and lists and projects you're trying to keep track of? My name's Dylan Stewart. They call me the Mac Whisperer, and you're in the right place because in today's lesson, I'm gonna teach you how I use Apple Reminders to stay organized and keep on top of everything in my life. Reminders is the unsung hero of the Apple ecosystem. Most people have completely overlooked it, and everyone else, well, they've just underutilized it. But not you, because after today's video, you're gonna know what this app is truly capable of. In today's video, I'm gonna teach you my five favorite uses of Apple Reminders. And if you stick around until the end of the video, I'm gonna drop my MacWhisperer Power Tip that is gonna make it even easier to keep on top of all your projects. So let's hop on in and get started. Before we start talking about the best uses for reminders, it's important we understand how to use the app. So let's start off by clicking on the app right here. Once you open up the Reminders app, up at the top, you're gonna see a bunch of pre-configured favorite lists. And then down below that, you're gonna see all of your lists, which can also be put into collections to organize different lists that have a similar topic. Lists are the core component of reminders, and they're the way you can separate your groceries list from your to-do list. So it's really important to have lists for specific functions. You can create a list by clicking on the Add List button in the lower right-hand corner here. From here, you can give your list a name, choose a color, even select an icon to make it really easy to find that list. But we'll talk more about that in a few minutes. Down in the lower left-hand corner, if you click the New Reminder button, it'll create a new reminder and you can choose which list you want it to go inside of. Or you can go into a list and press New Reminder in the lower left-hand corner of that list and it will automatically add it directly into that list, which is usually an easier way to do it. My first favorite use for reminders is just, well, a basic reminders list. It's easy to create one by clicking your Add List button down here and giving it a basic list like today's to-dos. And then you can pick whatever image you want or color. I'm just gonna leave this one simple. Let's click Done on it. And once we create a list, it automatically enters us directly into it. So now we need to add some of the items into this list. You can do that by clicking on the New Reminder button down here and then type or dictate whatever needs to go into it. I'm gonna go ahead and dictate it. When we're done dictating one of the reminders, I'm gonna press the return button on the keyboard, which will automatically create the next one. It works just like this. Walk the dog. Feed the cat. Buy groceries. Pick up Christian. Call mom. And then when you've created these reminders, you can click the little eye on the right-hand side here for you to choose whether you want to do it at a date, like maybe I want to do this later today or a specific time, or maybe I want to do it at a location, like when I arrive or leave my house. And then you click the Done button in the upper right-hand corner and you'll see the reminder right underneath it that shows how you're going to be alerted. Let's go ahead and add another one for Feed the Cat. I'm gonna set that to a date for tomorrow at 7 a.m. And we'll see that shows up right under there. What's nice about doing this kind of thing in a reminders list is once you've completed the task, all you have to do is click the little circle on the left like this, and that reminder disappears. But it's not really gone forever. You can click the three dots in the upper right-hand corner here and select Show Completed, and you'll see those completed items, which will make a little more sense in one of the other examples. So that's creating a basic reminder list. And my second favorite use of reminders is a grocery list. Let's go ahead and create one by clicking Add List in the lower right-hand corner here. We'll name it Market. We'll give it a nice picture. A little shopping cart. That looks perfect. But here where it says list type, you want to change it from standard to groceries. This means that as you add items directly onto this list, it will categorize them into common aisles like the milk aisle or the drinks aisle or the cereal aisle. Let's see how it works. I'm going to click done. And let's start adding some items. Carrots. Eggs. Milk. Cereal. Hamburger. Swiss cheese. And just like this, I've got a grocery list that's easy for me to take right into the grocery store. But that's not really the magic of the grocery list. The magic happens when you click your share button at the top here and share that list with your wife or your son or anyone who lives with you, just like that. And then when they accept that list, they can easily add groceries to it as well. And then whoever goes to the grocery store always knows what everybody needs. And you don't have to go to the grocery store and then come home and go, oh my God, nobody told me we're out of milk. Because everything's on the list and it makes it easy for everyone to add new items when they run out so that whenever you go to the store, you've got a perfect list. And this is one of those places where using the completed items is perfect because before you go to the grocery store, if you come in here and you click show completed, you can go, oh, do we have eggs? And check for them. And if you don't have any eggs, you can simply uncheck them. And then when you go to the grocery store, they'll be on your list ready for you to purchase them. So that's groceries. My third best use of reminders is a packing list. You know, when we travel, we tend to take the same things with us. But the problem is, if we forgot to put something on our list, we just don't have it for that trip. And if we're on a trip and we go, you know what, I should bring a bathing suit next time, where do we put that down? By creating a packing list, you instantly have an easy place for you to keep track of everything before you pack, and when you're on the trip, if you need to add additional items. Let's go ahead and do it like this. I'm gonna click add list. We're gonna call it packing list. I'm gonna change the color, nice green color, and we're gonna come down here and grab our little airplane so that it looks perfect and simple. Let's click the done button. And now let's add some of the things for our packing list. Razors. Phone cord. Bathing suit. Contact lenses. Extra socks. And then as you pack it, you just complete them one after the other after the other as soon as you put them into your suitcase. And while you're on that trip and you suddenly realize, you know what, I need to bring flip-flops to the next vacation, all you have to do is click New Reminders and add it. Flip-flops. And then the next time you go on a trip, come in here, click Show Completed, uncheck everything, and start all over. And you'll never leave anything behind ever again. It's perfect use for reminders. My fourth favorite use for reminders is to keep track of all of the movies and books that you want to read. Have you ever sat down to watch something on Netflix and you spend more time looking for the next thing to watch than you do actually watching it? It's super frustrating, but if you create a reminders list, including all of the movies you want to share with your son, or all of the movies you want to see with your wife, then they're all here easy for you to find. And you can even create different columns by clicking on the three dots in the upper right-hand corner here and saying view as columns. This allows you to easily create a new column for something like here are our Netflix movies. Or here are the movies we want to see on Max or Amazon Prime or anything. And then you can drag those movies right over to these separate columns so that when you open up Max or Netflix or whatever it is, you know exactly what you want to watch without having to fight with it. This is another great list to share with your son or your wife or your friends so that you can all work together to build the perfect movie list so that you're never bored and you never waste time trying to figure out what are we gonna watch? And for my fifth favorite use for reminders, I want to talk to you about something I call my to-purchase list. Here it is right down here. Have you ever been on a website and you've seen a product and you're thinking to yourself, I really want to buy that, but you're not ready to buy it now, and you're afraid, how am I going to remember to buy that? Where am I supposed to put that? I mean, sure, you can bookmark it, but don't you have enough bookmarks to keep track of already? That really doesn't help. What you need is an easy place to put it where you can be reminded to buy it later. And it's easy to do. Let's go ahead and hop over to Safari. Right from here, here's a shirt that I'm eager to buy. All I have to do is click the share button at the bottom of Safari and go right into the reminders list right here. It'll ask me which list I want to add it to, and I can click here and immediately find my to-purchase list right down here. And then I click add. And now that shirt shows up right at the bottom of my reminders list, and when it's time to purchase it, all I have to do is click on the little web link right here, and it jumps me right to that page where I can put it in my cart and send it on its way to me. But sometimes you're on an app like Facebook or TikTok or Instagram when you come across something you want to see. How do you add it to the reminders list from there? Well, it's super simple to do. Let's head over to Facebook first. Oh, that's an iPad stand. That looks awesome. I totally want to add that to my list. Now we're going to click the Shop Now button right here. But the problem is it opens up in the Facebook browser, which doesn't really let me drop things in reminders easily. But all I have to do is click on the three dots in the upper right corner here and choose Open in External Browser. Sometimes it will say Open in Safari, depending on the app. This takes that website and immediately puts it into Safari, where I've got that super simple share button, and I can click that, drop it in Reminders. It's already set on my to purchase list, and I can click Add, making it really easy to keep track of all of those products or all of those gifts you want to buy for others. And before I drop my MacWhisperer Pro Power Tip, there's one other thing I want to talk to you about as far as organizing your lists. You see, these pre-selected lists that show up at the top aren't the only lists you can add there. You can easily come into any one of your lists and press and hold on it and choose Pin, which will immediately put that list right at the top with the other ones. And if you don't need some of these pre-created lists like completed, I don't need to keep track of all of my completed reminders, you can press and hold on that and hide it to create space for the lists that you actually care about. Now, in just a moment, I'm gonna drop my MacWhisperer Pro Power Tip. But before I do, if you've already gotten great value from today's lesson, give it a thumbs up to make it super simple for other people to find it. And if you've got another suggestion for how you use reminders, or a comment or question, just drop it down below. I love to hear from you guys, and I'll always respond to every one of your messages. And if you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, guess what time it is? Go ahead and hit that subscription button and that notify bell so that you are always alerted whenever I drop new content. And now, let's get into the MacWhisperer Power Tip. Reminders is a super powerful app, and now you know all of these separate pieces about how to use it. But my power tip is all about how to quickly add things to your separate lists. The first thing you want to know is that Siri was made for reminders. So whether you use the side button or the magic words, you can summon Siri and then immediately have her add things directly into your reminders list. If you say, "Remind me to call my dad," it will immediately add that directly into your reminders. Now, it's important to note that it will add reminders into what's called your default list. So if you're not sure what your default list is, take a moment, swipe up, go into settings, and come all the way down to reminders here, and take a look at what it is. For me, my default list is called This Week, because that's where I put the majority of my reminders. So when I tell Siri to just add something in, that's where it goes. And as we can see here, there's Call My Dad. Let's add another one quickly. Remind me to book tickets for North Carolina. Just like that. But there's two other ways that you can easily add things directly into reminders. And one of them allows you to add it into any list you want. Works a little something like this. You're gonna press your side button or say your magic words and repeat after me. Add bananas to my market list. The phrase that you need to keep track of is add whatever it's called to the name of your list and then the word list. So add bananas to my market list. That makes it really easy for Siri to put things directly into any category you want. And you thought it was done, right? I have one more power tip that absolutely changes everything. When you're in many different places on your phone, like notes or messages or email or even Safari, you can come right in and you can say to Siri, "Remind me about this." And it will take whatever it sees on the screen and drop that right into your default reminders list. Now I warn you, don't try doing "remind me about this" and then also give it a date or a time or a specific list. It gets it confused. It's just a very simple way to drop something directly into your default list, which you can then move into another section or add a reminder to really easily by just clicking the little eye and clicking the date, the time, or the location. That's right, just by using Siri, you can keep track of everything on all of your lists. That's what I've got for today's lesson, all about my favorite uses for reminders. I hope you got a lot of value out of it, and I hope it helps you stay more organized. My name's Dylan Stewart. They call me the Mac Whisperer, and it's my passion and profession to help you get more done with your Apple products than you ever thought possible. And I'll see you next time. Thank you.